Look at the camera. You're so goofy.
Growing up, school was always fun, and I had such a brazen way of showing my excitement for the classrooms, the learning, my teachers, and my friends. But when I was young, I didn't expect my high school years to go like this, or to end like this. I've learned so much and lost so much, and I honestly don't think I'll miss it very much. Overall, I valued the personal strengths I've learned to grow and the knowledge relating to my future that I required from teachers, experience, and even my peers, which changed me for the good. In retrospect, freshman year doesn't seem interesting at all, but I know for a fact, at the moment, I was in an ebullient mood almost every day when in school. I remember doing ROTC and loving the program, but hating the extra science class that came with it, and don't get me started on physical training, but most of the time I had PT and gym class in the same day, and that contributed to my misery big time. Aside from ROTC, I was in a pre-AP English class with a very young teacher who spent more time joking around with us and getting to know us personally than teaching us. And honestly, I'm not complaining, although I do wish I got past Of Mice and Men, like the other English classes in my grade. It quickly occurred to me how difficult high school would be compared to middle school, and once I figured out that doing well freshman year positively affects you in the long run, I focused on my grades and getting school over with. It seems as if as soon as I became comfortable and motivated to get things done at Central, a deadly virus had to swoop in and was detrimental to the daily routine I've built up for years. Granted, I am gifted with the ability to get things done remotely and actually prefer online classes. I excelled COVID year and received straight A's. When I came back to school, I felt like a different person with different goals. Things at home became a lot harder, and I was struggling with even staying focused on my classes. Once I started picking up classes that allowed me to express myself, I became more grounded, calm, and overall present.
Jayana, excuse me, sorry. Jayana is a very bubbly and positive student. She always kind of comes in and brings in a little ray of sunshine. She's always happy. She's one of the only students who actually comes in and actually takes an interest and says, "How are you, mister? What's going on?" It's a very positive spirit to the room.
In these classes, I learned how to prioritize my work over my own personal problems. It allowed me to put those problems to the side and be in the moment.
Gianna's work when it comes to videos is pretty good. She does a lot of hard work when she's motivated. However, she tends to like to go to the goofy dancing and silly side of videos, which there's nothing wrong with that. But she does make her videos very fun and entertaining.
My core classes, such as English, were helpful in allowing me to divulge my strength in multiple choice and essay writing. Although I struggled in some ways, my teacher, Mr. Forbes, helped me feel confident and ready for the exam. Senior year is where I was thrown into a lot more adult situations sooner than I expected. I had to leave my parents' home and provide for myself, all while keeping the motivation to even get up in the morning and go to school.
Well, ever since we've met, Jana has always been a good student ever since, the start, since 8th grade. Always done all her work, very good grades. So, as a student, academically, she's always really been good. So, I haven't really seen much change to that because she's always been a top of her.
I am grateful that I stood in school and was able to finish strong despite my head spiraling 24/7.
Hey, just working. Working hard so I can please you.
And although I was assailed by these struggles and thoughts, I kept a positive demeanor. I learned the importance of maturing and using my words correctly. My words and actions defined me as a person and as a worker. My senior year consisted of a lot of working both in and out of school. I learned more and more about time management and being grateful for my days off. I'll forever be grateful for the guidance and advice I've gotten from my teachers this year regarding in school and even out. With the guidance and learning I've done this year, especially in my art classes, I decided on going to college and pursuing art and not letting struggles stop me from getting the education I deserve.
Jana's changed a lot from the first year to her senior year. Her first year, she was very bubbly, very excited. She's still like that, but she's kind of become much more of an adult and had to had to fight the struggles of the real world, and she's carried it very well, but she's become much more of a mature and grown person, much more than a lot of kids have had to do.
My once insatiable mentality about school has grown to be more grateful for the words of wisdom and the free knowledge I can take with me to the real world. Although graduation can be sad for most, it's a celebration and breath of fresh air for me. I've worked hard for this and feel motivated to open up this next chapter, whatever that may be. I'll be free to indulge in hobbies and trips I wasn't able to while being confined to such a set schedule every day. I'll be more innovative when managing my life and taking schooling more seriously since it wasn't a walk in the park getting here. Overall, I'm very grateful to say that with these experiences, I feel a lot more prepared for after high school than I expected. And I am proud to say that I finally found symmetry within my goals on where I will go after this chapter ends. Where do I see myself taking all of this learning and experience after high school? I see myself taking it to the moon. Like, I feel like I can do anything since I've already come so far. Like, I literally feel like nothing can stop me unless I stop myself. So I'm very excited.